Today, the global food supply could feed nearly 12 billion people, nearly twice the current world population. 80% of this global food supply is produced by family farming, and this type of agriculture employs over 40% of the global working population. As a matter of fact, the General Assembly of the United Nations declared 2014 as the International Year of Family Farming. So, this family farming which feeds most of us today, what does it look like? Over the course of a year, to answer this question, a group of young agronomists decided to utilise their end-of-year internships to meet farmers around the world. They travelled to India, France, Ecuador, Cameroon and Canada. Through this film, they invite us to discover the diversity of family farming, what it is and what it is not, and under which conditions family farmers can meet the challenges of tomorrow. India is a mosaic of cultures, histories and environments. The rains and winds that sweep the country are crucial for agriculture. After the monsoon season in the western part of the country, farmers from the state of Gujarat work a semi-arid landscape.
सीसम से राजापुरी से हापुस से लंगड़ो से चीकू से पसी नारियल से पसी आपड़े सीताफल रामफल बदीज जतनी हमारे यहीं से ने केरी थी मारी बदीज फल फड़े आवे हम टोटल उस्त कोई पन हमारे बाजार में थी लावार नहीं रहे हम टोटल उस्त में पका आवे हमें चार सोकरा मारा मारा कुटुम ना चार सोकरा से पसी चार बहुत से मार मार को कुटुम सारे ते जीवन चले हम हमार 35 जन कुटुंब छ 35
By diversifying its production, this farm manages to satisfy all the nutritional needs of the family on a small piece of land. But these farmers also show us that family farming is not exclusively geared towards self-sufficiency, as some of their products are sold. Their vegetables can be found on local markets, their milk is sold all over India, and their mangoes are exported to Europe. However, family farming does not always look like this.
એને દાણ દાણમાં કપાસ પાપડી તુર ચુની ઘઉંનો ભૂસો અને કુસકી અને આ લીલી જુવાર અને હાથે પૂરી ત્યાં મિક્સ કાપીને નાખીએ
Specializing in milk production, this farm shows that family farms are not always diversified. Both of these farms produce milk that is delivered every day to the world's largest federation of cooperatives, AMUL. The Federation has increased the income of many farmers by providing them with access to a stable and lucrative market. Started by the AMUL cooperative model, These changes in the dairy industry, called the White Revolution, later received state support. The government recognised the benefit of encouraging rural development while increasing Indian dairy production, and therefore also its contribution to the food security of the country. By supporting infrastructure for milk collection services, this policy allowed many farmers to improve their living conditions while delivering affordable milk to urban areas.
Vasudhara is created to provide the livelihood to the milk producers. The interest is that we are providing all the backward linkages, like loan to purchase the animals, then cattle feed and other feed supplements. We are also providing animal husbandry and veterinary services. And after all, our most critical work is to provide training to the milk producers, then provide all the input facility needed for milk production.
One of the main goals of this policy was to encourage as many households as possible, even the poorest ones, to buy animals. The original slogan of the Animal Federation stated this explicitly.
Gai lao, garibi hatao.
अच्छा चार गाय छे एक वाछड़ी छे सवानो रसोट नो बे पहिले 5 दिवस नी मजूरी एक जन नी थाय एम
Today, over 3 million farmers make a decent daily income from the milk they sell, thanks to AMIL. But what is more astonishing is that the majority of farmers from this cooperative have less than 5 bovines. By giving them access to a stable market, to both technical and financial support, the Federation contributes to generating revenue, thus improving many farmers' living conditions. Today, the AMIL Federation of Cooperatives collects over 7 million litres of milk per day.
En soutenant ces formes d'agriculture familiale et ces petits élevages, l'Inde est effectivement devenue le premier producteur de lait au monde. Elle a réussi à satisfaire la demande nationale en produits laitiers, contribuant ainsi à assurer la sécurité alimentaire du pays, mais surtout à faire vivre de nombreuses familles d'éleveurs qui, par conséquent, n'ont pas eu besoin de rejoindre les bidonvilles de Mumbai ou encore de New Delhi.
Toutefois, la faim et la pauvreté sont encore des problématiques actuelles en Inde. C'est pourquoi il est important d'avoir des projets qui prennent en compte l'accès aux différents moyens de production, que ce soit la terre, l'eau ou encore le crédit et la formation.
But family farming is not only a type of agriculture that exists in so-called developing countries, producing on small land allotments with small herds of cattle and a few hand tools. Family farming is also widely found in so-called developed countries. In France, before the Second World War, a large part of the agricultural production came from small family farms producing a diversity of crops. This type of production has evolved after the long period of conflict. Various public policies, including the Common Agricultural Policy of the European Union, have enabled access to high-yielding seeds, fertilisers, herbicides and pesticides, as well as mechanisation thanks to beneficial loans. In France, agricultural organisations and cooperatives were also developed to represent the agricultural profession to the public authorities. Through stabilised market prices, they also helped to facilitate the commercialisation of agricultural products. In order to remain competitive and produce low-cost food, farmers have often needed to expand and specialise their farming practices to maintain a decent income. This family pig farm in Brittany is a clear example of this process.
Mon père et mon grand-père sont venus s'installer ici, à Troumé, où on est là. Et il a acheté cette ferme-là, à Troumé, en 52 ou 3. Elle avait 12 vaches et 4 ou 5 truies. Donc on a vécu jusque dans les années 70, en gros, comme ça. Et là, il a commencé déjà, mon frère, à s'orienter vers la production porcine. Il fallait produire. Dans les années 60, on importait des productions agricoles. On ne produisait pas assez en France, il fallait en importer de tout hein, pour se nourrir. Et finalement, on a très bien travaillé au niveau du lait, pareil, au niveau du... on est tombé en surproduction dans les années 80, après les incitations.
Similarly, as was seen during the White Revolution in India, French family farms managed to meet and even surpass the national food needs, therefore turning France into a major exporter.
C'est vrai que c'est une évolution, c'est entre 78 et 2000, en 22 ans, on a quand même multiplié par 4 la production.
Voilà, bah nous on est une exploitation polyculture élevage, c'est-à-dire qu'on a 120 hectares de terre. On a un atelier de porc de 400 truies naisseurs-engraisseurs.
Specialization and expansion of agricultural systems can also be problematic, not only to farmers, but also to society as a whole.
On produit à peu près 800 tonnes de céréales et il nous en faut 3000 pour les cochons, donc on est autosuffisant qu'à un tiers.
Les céréales, blé, ou les issues de céréales viennent. Sont produits en France sûrement, enfin, mais par contre les matières azotées, les protéines viennent en grande partie du Brésil ou des États-Unis.
To meet the daily needs of animals, imported soybean cakes are currently the most profitable source of protein for farmers. This low-cost feed allows farmers to carry on producing cheap meat, thus satisfying consumer demand.
L'avenir de la filière, ça sera toujours d'avoir une production de qualité, une production forte, avec des coûts pas très élevés. Produire un kilo de viande le moins cher possible, ça sera toujours, le consommateur sera toujours l'arbitre, en quelque sorte, il ne voudra pas payer trop cher.
Family farming does sometimes have a negative impact on the environment. Indeed. Minerals accumulated in soybeans from the United States, Brazil and Argentina eventually end up spread throughout the land in Brittany via animal manure. These excessive minerals can cause problems such as the development of green algae. Nevertheless, farmers continue to evolve their practices in an attempt to respond to environmental challenges such as reducing their energy consumption.
Toutes les trappes qu'on voit ici, donc elles sont motorisées, elles se ferment au-dessous de 13 degrés et toute l'air apporté dans les cochons est forcé à passer à travers les tuyaux verts.
By reusing the heat produced by the animals to heat the air coming from outside, the farmer manages to make significant energy savings. In order to keep up with public health challenges, farmers are also innovative in livestock management practices.
La coopérative nous oriente vers un porc sans antibiotiques, donc déjà on va vers la qualité sanitaire du consommateur aussi.
What we need to remember is that family farmers are quite capable of adapting to the changing demands of society, so long as we support them and pay them properly. Over the course of history, some farmers have been able to invest and modernize their farms. However, others who were not able to stay as competitive were eventually forced to sell their land, generally to larger neighboring farmers.
Une sur trois disparaît. Sur Pipouillac, on a 160 exploitations, 165 je crois, dans les années 80, aujourd'hui 42 je crois exactement. Donc en l'espace de 20 ans, divisé par 4.
Today's requirement for large and significant operating investments represents a real obstacle for young farmers wanting to establish themselves and for families trying to pass the farm on to the next generation.
De réelles installations, il n'y en a quasiment pas. Pour s'installer, il faut cette surface, il la faut telle comme elle est, puisque maintenant on ne peut plus vivre avec 25 ou 30 vaches, donc c'est le minimum qu'il faut.
Mais l'exploitation sans les animaux et le matériel, on demande 1 million d'euros.
Seulement le gros problème, c'est que ça représente quand même un investissement qui est lourd, afin des capitaux importants à apporter, surtout quand on voit qu'il faut minimum entre 50 et 70% d'apport personnel. C'est vrai que ça réduit vraiment le nombre de candidats.
Purchasing new farmlands to settle has become very difficult. Many projects have been created to assist the settlement process and improve access to lands for the new generation of family farmers. For example, farm incubators are strategies that assist young farmers.
J'ai toujours pas eu envie de travailler dans un bureau, mais plutôt de démarrer sur une terre, mais n'étant pas fils d'agriculteur, j'avais pas de terre. Étant sorti de mes études, j'avais pas non plus de moyens.
Family farming is not just composed of farms that are transferred within the same family. France, like most developed countries, has supported a network of family farms with production directed mostly towards the domestic market. However, this is not the case in many other countries. Located in Central Africa, Cameroon has a diversity of ecosystems, promoting a wide variety of crops, including coffee and cocoa. Historically, these two crops were introduced by Europeans and were originally grown in order to meet the needs of colonial homelands. After independence in 1960, and with the support of the Cameroonian government, numerous family farmers started to specialise in the production of these export crops. However, specialization in agricultural products cultivated solely for export can be risky for farmers, as their income is dependent on fluctuating global market prices. This risk became a reality in the 1990s, when an increase in the world production of coffee and cocoa led to a sharp drop in the price of these commodities. Many vulnerable farming families relying on these crops faced great difficulties.
The price of the coffee now cannot attract me to still continue to work for coffee because I work and I cannot have balance. Only the chemical to spray, all this, if you calculate, you will not balance what you spend to have any balance for yourself.
Facing this crisis in coffee and cocoa prices, many farmers decided to diversify their production and focus more on producing crops destined to be sold in local markets.
I started doing gardening, even though I planted coffee. But the coffee business was a very tough one. At the time you harvest coffee and they will not even buy it. I plant cabbages, carrot, leeks, corn, and sometimes cocoyams. Yes.
Even though originally intended for the local market, vegetable production gradually entered the African regional market.
I always sell it just the local market at Santa here, yeah, to the buy and sells. Then my crops always go, but it's transported by the buy and sells to Gabon, Nigeria, the neighboring countries. Yes.
By choosing to grow more crops that are directly consumable and can be sold on the local market, farmers are less vulnerable to the risks associated with being dependent on an unstable global market.
So now I go back to the food crop, so that even if they don't buy it, I can eat some. Yes.
I wouldn't starve. I'll hardly starve. Except they cut my hands, except the soil is not there. If the soil is there and I have the energy to work, I'll always have food.
In Cameroonian society, while men tend to generate income via cash crops or through off-farm activities, the women of the family commonly produce crops for home consumption. These women have acquired detailed knowledge about their environment and land, which enables them to create very complex, diverse crop associations. Their diverse plant associations defend against insect infestations and limit the risk of crop failure.
on one mound. We plant cassava, maize, groundnut, yams, cuckoo yams. To feed the family, I do sell some, then part of it you do in feeding.
Even if they lose one crop, they will still have many other crops to feed their families. As in many other cases over the course of history, family farmers have proven their ability to react to new constraints. Family farming is not a fixed agriculture, unable to break away from tradition. The coffee and cocoa crisis weakened the economy and resulted in high national debt. The state was forced to reduce public investments, which led to serious problems in the labour market and caused massive layoffs in cities. As a result, many urban dwellers migrated towards the countryside in order to find work in agriculture. This meant that unemployed children, brothers and sisters and in-laws, all flooded towards their rural family farmlands.
You know, a concours is an entrance examination into the public service. So I was not successful. So I came back here. I was forced to learn driving. And then I realized that this driving profession is somehow hand to mouth. So I saw how my friends too were living well as farmers.
Family farming absorbs or releases manpower according to the needs of other sectors of the economy. Therefore, it is a great regulator of the labour market.
Dans la famille, on est plus de 40 personnes. 40 personnes.
Ils peuvent vraiment supporter
le travail. Si on a beaucoup de plantations aujourd'hui, des hectares de cacao, c'est grâce à ça, la main d'œuvre.
In order to take advantage of the available family labour, these three brothers from southeast Cameroon were able to expand their acreage on a zone still sparsely populated and minimally developed. But in more populated areas, such as the northwest of Cameroon, such agricultural expansions have contributed to land conflicts. Because of the development of vegetable farms, some transhumans migratory cattle grazers have encountered a decline in the amount of available grazing areas. These different forms of family farms are forced to compete with each other.
We have a farmer grazer problem. We have a minitin and like bracken fen, where they grow on forest, they grow on hill, they occupy all the grass hill, and we have a plenty problem in grazing.
To adapt to this new environment, some grazers have been forced to settle in one location. This radical change, strongly encouraged by the state, forced the Fulani herders to change their traditional way of life. Some have converted to vegetable cropping, and others have developed new livestock rearing practices in order to maintain a decent income on a smaller amount of land.
Better they are go transhumer, but for we now so will not go transhumer. We try to prove land to make pasture improvement, to go to dry season, to transhuma. It's too worry we. So when you have your pasture improvement, you can live with your animal all the years for one place. You can don't go transhuma.
Au Cameroun, suite à la chute des prix du café et du cacao notamment, les agriculteurs ont dû s'adapter. En se diversifiant, donc au sein d'un même ménage, aujourd'hui on va avoir des cultures vivrières qui vont être destinées à l'autoconsommation et également au marché local, et quelquefois des cultures de rente destinées à la commercialisation sur le marché national et international. Donc les agriculteurs vont être moins dépendants des aléas des marchés internationaux, mais vont être dépendants de plusieurs cultures et de plusieurs marchés.
Aujourd'hui, le Cameroun a pris conscience de l'importance de l'agriculture familiale pour le développement du pays et il appuie des initiatives de groupements de producteurs. Les agriculteurs n'ont pas tous pu adapter leur système de production et comme on a pu le voir avec le cas des éleveurs transhumants, ils ont dû parfois s'orienter vers des activités annexes pour subvenir aux besoins de leur famille.
The need to secure income through additional activities outside the family farm is necessary for many farmers throughout the world, such as in Ecuador. The Cayambe region is located in the heart of the Andes, in a valley surrounded by mountains, with peaks rising to 6,000 meters above sea level. Farmers grow crops and breed animals in an equatorial mountain climate. However, agricultural production is not always sufficient to meet the needs of families. Often, at least one member of the family combines their work on the family farm with an off-farm income-generating activity.
Trabajo de ahí, de lo que salgo del centro infantil, yo vengo para acá, me dedico en lo que es la agricultura. Y lo que tengo de terreno, tengo una hectárea, en lo que es cebolla, papas, habas, alberja, siembro hierba también, tengo ganados. La verdad, nosotros, o sea, por plata más se trabajaría, porque a veces nosotros tenemos otras necesidades aquí en la casa y no nos abastece si el terreno solo para sembrar, a veces no tenemos suficiente plata para cultivar como es debido en el cultivo, entonces por esa razón es que tenemos que salir nosotros a trabajar.
Family farming is not just composed of households where all income is generated from the family farm. Money earned off the farm can also be used to invest in the farm. In the Cayambe region, other types of agriculture can be found. Some farms, termed capitalists, produce flowers destined for export. These farms do not belong to those who work the land, but to Ecuadorian or foreign investors. Investors' main objective is to maximize the profit rates of their investments. They continuously compare the state of their investment in agriculture to what they could make if they were to invest in other sectors of the economy, such as industry or public services. These capitalist farms fully depend on hired labourers, mainly farmers from the surrounding family farms, who work in parallel on their own lands.
Sí, porque por económico pues, no hay que salir de venta de nuestro terreno, hemos salido a la florícola. Estar en la casa me hace falta la plata.
Agricultural production in the region therefore depends heavily on these farmers employed by the florícolas. As far back as the era of Spanish colonialization, both family farms and capitalist farms have shared the same territory. However, it is the family farmers who tend to be marginalised and, for example, have limited access to irrigation. These two types of farms also manage their workforce in very different ways.
Por eso es lo que hemos tratado de hacer entre mi familia, hemos buscado de incrementar, hacer propias fuentes de trabajo para no andar sufriendo así. Es que de otras empresas nos botan. Cuenta de decir, bueno, si quieres trabaja y si no, vete.
This farmer speaks directly of the definition of family farming.
Ce que sont les agriculteurs familiales, je mets au pluriel parce qu'il y a des formes assez différentes, mais ce sont des agricultures qui sont mises en œuvre dans des fermes, dans des unités de production agricoles, familiales, à savoir que les agriculteurs et leurs familles travaillent pour leur propre compte, mobilisent pour l'essentiel leur propre main-d'œuvre familiale, avec comme objectif d'améliorer leurs revenus en comparaison avec ce qui pourrait leur revenir s'ils travaillaient ailleurs. À quoi s'ajoute souvent que les familles sont aussi détentrices des moyens de production.
Mmh.
sont bien des entreprises, donc qui pratiquent l'agriculture, bien sûr. Et c'est des entreprises d'un type un peu particulier, dans le sens où les relations entre les gens qui travaillent dans ce genre d'entreprise ne sont pas des relations de patron à salarié, hein, c'est des relations de père à fils, de mère à fille, d'époux-épouse, enfin c'est des relations familiales, quoi, hein. Cette absence de rapport salarial dans l'exploitation familiale en fait un très bon régulateur du marché du travail. On licencie un ouvrier, on licencie un ouvrier agricole, mais on ne licencie pas son fils. Un chef d'exploitation familiale ne fera cela qu'à la condition qu'il soit à peu près assuré que le fils, hein, lorsqu'il va partir en ville pour trouver du travail, eh bien, trouvera assez facilement des conditions de travail et de rémunération au moins équivalentes à celles qu'il aurait eues s'il avait continué à travailler sur l'exploitation familiale. Il est clair que l'agriculture familiale, de ce point de vue-là, présente un potentiel bien plus grand, hein, que les entreprises capitalistes pour lesquelles, évidemment, encore une fois, hein, tout travail supplémentaire est un coût supplémentaire et donc est un profit en moins.
L'agriculture familiale n'est donc pas qu'une petite agriculture diversifiée, ou encore une agriculture qui produit sur de petites surfaces et sans équipement. L'agriculture familiale, lorsqu'on lui en donne les moyens, peut aussi être très moderne et très productive.
L'agriculture familiale n'est pas qu'une agriculture de pauvres et de pays en développement. Elle n'est pas non plus une agriculture qui produit seulement pour l'autoconsommation et les marchés locaux. L'agriculture familiale, au contraire, est souvent rémunératrice pour les familles d'agriculteurs du monde entier. Et elle peut également être tournée vers les marchés nationaux et internationaux.
L'agriculture familiale n'est pas forcément une agriculture respectueuse de l'environnement, ni une agriculture à faible investissement, ou une agriculture qui se transmet facilement. D'ailleurs, on ne devrait pas dire une agriculture familiale, mais plutôt des agricultures familiales.
Family farms operate in a wide variety of ecological, economic, and social contexts. Even though family farms may vary in their environmental impact, they all have at least one common factor: the way they manage their wealth. Investments are balanced between developing the farm and improving the well-being of the family. The family-oriented nature of this type of agriculture makes it an especially good regulator of the labour market, which is not the case in capitalist agriculture. The family-oriented characteristic of this type of agriculture shapes a social structure. However, it still says nothing about the production methods practiced on these farms. Is this family-oriented characteristic enough to meet all the challenges of tomorrow? Historically, most so-called developed countries have supported their family farms and encouraged production to be oriented towards the domestic market, thereby laying the foundation for strong economic development. This was the case in North America during the conquest of the West, in Western Europe, and in post-war Japan. The agricultural systems of the past were created to meet the needs of society at the time. As our world evolves, certain family farming systems are no longer as functional as they once were. Therefore, they have to adapt in order to satisfy today's societal needs.
Faut pas cracher là-dessus sur la révolution, sur cette révolution-là qui a eu un moment en agriculture. Mais aujourd'hui, c'est plus les attentes de la société. La façon dont on a monté les modèles agricoles. On a produit du lait qu'on a vendu aux coopératives pour acheter de la poudre de lait pour faire boire les veaux. Bon. Tu produis du blé sur ton exploitation que tu vends à la coopérative pour racheter de l'aliment qui revient chez toi. Il y a quand même des choses qui ne sont pas cohérentes là-dedans.
As in all types of agriculture, family farms have been given a challenge to produce quality food for a growing world population, while preserving natural resources and generating income in rural areas, ultimately assisting the fight against poverty. Our agricultural world exists in a mosaic of contexts. It is important to support the emerging solutions that are adapted to their needs, and to encourage a type of agriculture that will be able to survive and meet our future needs. A source of many innovations, the family farms we met demonstrated abilities to adapt to meet challenges. To achieve this, for example, some farmers have based their production on local and renewable resource development.
So, our farming,
ખેતી માં ખર્ચ કઈ ઘટે લેબર ખર્ચ ઘટવાનો નથી બરાબર તો પોતાનું બિયારણ પોતાનું જ ખાતર
C'est pour ça que le principe nous de base c'est de diminuer les charges. Parce que le premier sous-gagné c'est celui que t'as pas dépensé. Et la diminution des charges passe par le pâturage. Par les vaches à l'herbe qui vont toutes seules ramasser leur fourrage. Il n'y a pas besoin de matériel.
By limiting their dependence on inputs, such as seeds, feed for the animals, or fertilizers from outside sources, they profit, economically speaking. In addition, they don't have to deal with some industries known to contribute to the degradation of natural resources and whose prices can also be volatile. Throughout history, family farmers have always invented a variety of techniques to enable them to benefit from their environment. Often these techniques are based on the intensification of beneficial ecological processes and the use of local and renewable resources. These techniques are sometimes grouped under the term agroecology.
Nombreuses techniques permettant de respecter ces contraintes environnementales existent déjà, ont été répertoriées, il y a encore du travail, mais enfin on en connaît beaucoup, hein, donc l'agroforesterie, les associations agriculture-élevage, les rotations, les associations avec des légumineuses.
There is still much to discover and develop regarding the agroecological techniques we use today. However, a number of solutions are already being used by farmers worldwide.
I have trees in my farm. I have useful trees. Then I have trees to shade my cocoa trees. Yes, what I don't go away with all the trees, because I leave some to get shelter. Yes, in my farm. Then jansanga is for food. I have mangoes, apples. I have a lot.
On n'a que des avantages en fait à avoir des animaux et des cultures vivrières. D'ailleurs, labourage et pâturage, oui, ils sont les deux mamelles de la France, mais ça veut dire les deux mamelles au même endroit en fait. Parce que maintenant on a un peu perdu de vue, on a tendance à faire de l'élevage ou des céréales. Et en fait, quand on fait les deux, on a le fumier des animaux, les animaux mangent les pailles, mangent les grains. Le son et tous les issues de grains. On fait souvent donc le grand classique où c'est graminées, enfin céréales et légumineuses quoi.
Comme seigle lentillon.
Voilà comme l'exemple, comme dit Béa, seigle lentillon. Et donc le lentillon, enfin c'est une légumineuse donc ça apporte de l'azote au sol.
Production diversification seems to be an important lever to promote agroecological processes. The complexity of the production associations may, however, require the use of certain techniques and specific tools that enable precise control.
Ces systèmes de production agricole, disons, alors comment les appeler, disons, appelons-les agroécologiques, c'est un terme relativement large encore aujourd'hui, et se traduit donc bien souvent par une demande en travail supérieure. Hein, et il est certain que si on attend des agriculteurs, et des agriculteurs familiaux en particulier, qu'ils s'y adonnent davantage, eh bien, la première condition, ça va être de faire en sorte que ce travail supplémentaire qui va leur être demandé d'une certaine manière, eh bien, soit rémunéré.
If this condition is respected, this type of family agroecological agriculture could generate income in rural areas, a major challenge we face today. By creating more jobs per acre, it has real potential to reduce unemployment in the north and the south. It would also help decrease the rural exodus and prevent the swelling slums in developing countries where the population continues to grow rapidly.
Et la dernière chose, c'est de faire de l'emploi, c'est-à-dire optimiser notre système de production pour qu'il y ait le plus d'emplois, fixer l'emploi sur la terre, localement, avec toutes les conséquences sociales que ça a sur les communes et l'occupation du territoire.
si on souhaite voir ce type d'agriculture plus agroécologique se généraliser, eh bien, il va falloir accepter que ce travail supplémentaire qui va être demandé soit rémunéré. Donc ça va de pair, oui, je le pense, avec des prix agricoles et donc des prix alimentaires plus élevés.
A sustainable farm has to sustain the farmer first before it can sustain society and the environment.
To receive more value for their work, some family farms sell their products locally via short food circuits. This decreases transportation costs as well as limiting the number of intermediaries, thereby increasing their profit share. These initiatives also establish a direct connection between farmers and consumers. Systems known as CSAs in Canada, short for Community Supported Agriculture, accomplish just that.
CSA is an important part of what we do, and it's important because in January, when we're starting to plan the farm, we contact our CSA customers and we request their deposit. So they give us money up front, usually in February, and it's a good chunk of money with which we can buy our seed, we can start ordering our compost and our amendments, anything that you need before you have vegetables to sell.
The nice thing about CSA and retail at farmers market is that the income is always consistent. We grow our crop, we know what we're going to get for our crop. If we're growing corn only, we don't know. That price will be determined by the international marketplace.
These systems have many advantages for farmers and consumers, but are only part of the puzzle to respond to our current societal food needs. Other types of marketing systems have to be built in order to include more farmers and consumers, until we are able to feed even the largest of cities. On-farm transformation of agricultural products is another way to increase the added value of products for farmers. It is also a way to widen the range of locally available products, no matter the season.
Eh bien, pour une petite ferme, même comme nous, c'est avantageux la transformation parce que ça permet d'avoir une valeur ajoutée à notre produit, donc d'engager plus de personnes pour la même superficie de ferme, la même grandeur de ferme. Fait qu'avec 70 vaches, au lieu de faire vivre 3 personnes, on peut faire vivre 6, 7 personnes, 8 avec le comptoir de la fromagerie. Fait que c'est 8 personnes qui ont un salaire à temps plein au lieu de 3.
Consuming locally at a scale relevant to each product is a way for consumers to contribute to the development of agricultural practices and to participate in directing the evolution of our food systems.
Rutabaga. What do you think?
The piece I think consumers have to understand is that the agricultural food system is a co-creation of consumers' choices driving farmers' choices. So the way the system's set up today, there's a huge wall between consumers and farmers in the processing and distribution and retailing, where the only real thing that passes through that is price. Values really don't pass back. So if consumers want to change, if they want a different farming system, agricultural food system, then they have to make different choices. And the only real way to do that is through direct connections, whether that's farmers markets, CSA programs, working with a food co-op in the city, purchasing from farmers and working with consumers.
These farmers who decided to adopt agroecological production systems or short value chain marketing systems or both are commonly small scale farmers.
Qu'est-ce que l'agriculture paysanne? Eh bien, à mon sens, c'est une agriculture familiale. De ce point de vue-là, pas de problème. J'entends par là que le caractère familial du travail demeure, hein, ça, il n'y a pas de souci. Mais par contre, en plus, cette agriculture familiale bien met en œuvre des systèmes de production reposant avant tout sur des ressources locales et effectivement assurant une production destinée à des marchés aussi relativement de proximité.
There appears to be consensus on what type of agriculture should dominate the 21st century. It must be an agriculture that will produce a sufficient amount of quality food to feed a growing population, be low polluting, and contribute to the fight against poverty and hunger in the world, as well as creating income in rural areas. All of these points ultimately characterize family farming and small-scale agriculture specifically.
Pourtant, les agriculteurs qui tentent de répondre au mieux à ces problèmes sont rarement soutenus par leurs États et sont bien souvent en difficulté. Si les consommateurs peuvent contribuer à orienter leur agriculture, seules les politiques publiques ont le pouvoir d'accompagner les agriculteurs et les citoyens à modifier durablement leurs pratiques. Cet accompagnement contribuera à démocratiser l'accès de tous à une nourriture produite localement et dans le respect de l'environnement.
Il faut que les politiques fassent un choix. On est dans le tournant pour les paysans, c'est clair, de choix d'agriculture là, on est dans le virage. Il y aura beau avoir des fermes comme les nôtres, des systèmes qui sont alternatifs, c'est bien, c'est super, et nous on est motivés pour ça, on communique, on a envie que ça bouge, il n'y a aucun souci, c'est pas suffisant. On le voit, c'est pas suffisant. Il y en a beaucoup qui aimeraient bien, mais le déclic il sera politique, c'est évident.
In many situations, the problems for farmers revolve primarily around access to stable and profitable markets. They also need access to means of production, such as microcredits, training, agricultural research results, and, most importantly, access to land and water resources. Access to these means of production needs to be addressed in public policies in order to allow small-scale family agriculture to develop.
Dans plusieurs pays du monde, des politiques d'aide à la production et de stabilisation des prix ont été mises en place et existent encore. Au-delà des problématiques liées aux facteurs de production, comme la terre et l'eau, le problème majeur des exploitations familiales, partout dans le monde, reste celui du prix de leurs produits.
With the gradual liberalization of agricultural markets, the prices paid for most food products have decreased over the decades. However, this downward price trend, presented as a necessary condition for the well-being of all consumers, poses problems for farmers, especially in developing countries where farmers represent the vast majority of the population. These farmers are producers before being consumers, and the falling agricultural prices have led to a decline in their income. They now face difficulties and have to compete with imported staple foods produced by a more competitive agriculture, cheaper than they can produce themselves. Indeed, a highly mechanized farmer produces up to 1,000 times more grain than a farmer working manually. With the liberalization of agricultural trade, farmers face direct competition from those operating at lower cost and with many different production capacities. This largely explains one of the great paradoxes of our world. Today, most of those suffering from hunger are farmers.
La libéralisation des marchés agricoles n'est pourtant pas qu'un problème des pays pauvres. Aujourd'hui, même les exploitations familiales françaises les plus capitalisées en souffrent et continueront d'en souffrir, car elles ne seront jamais aussi compétitives que les immenses exploitations capitalistes brésiliennes, néo-zélandaises ou ukrainiennes, qui sont basés sur une très forte mécanisation, une main-d'œuvre bon marché et de grandes économies d'échelle. Aujourd'hui, même les exploitations européennes et nord-américaines, avec les plus gros tracteurs et les machines de traite les plus performantes, ont besoin de subventions en grande quantité pour compenser les faibles prix de vente et l'augmentation constante des charges de production. Pourtant, elles ne pourront pas continuer à toujours s'agrandir et investir dans du capital indéfiniment sans quitter le modèle familial. Il s'agira alors d'un modèle d'agriculture capitaliste, car seuls des investisseurs pourront racheter ce type de ferme.
In this liberalized model, farming is more of a business than a family affair, and family farms are replaced by capitalist farms. The farmer is no longer the farm manager concerned with sustainability of production, but rather a simple worker. The owner is no longer a farmer who has a long-term vision for his business by controlling risk, but an investor who would give up the farm if other more lucrative opportunities arose.
Après avoir vu la force de développement de l'agriculture familiale lorsque les marchés sont stables et rémunérateurs, que penser de la tendance actuelle qui est de supprimer les barrières tarifaires sur les denrées agricoles?
Dans chaque pays du monde, ces barrières tarifaires pourraient constituer des revenus fiscaux qui assureraient la stabilisation et l'augmentation des prix payés aux producteurs.
Is it just a romantic idea for us to live in a world that supports family farmers, farmers who practice agroecology and sell their products locally, while still being able to make a decent living? Perhaps instead, a pragmatic decision needs to be made by all agricultural stakeholders, as well as every citizen in our society. We can promote this type of agriculture, and what's more, we can encourage these much-needed public policies.
Une myriade de solutions politiques existent et restent à inventer pour soutenir l'agriculture et, par là même, l'économie dans son ensemble.
Through these encounters with farmers around the world, we were able to discover the diversity of family farming. Using manual tools, an ox or a tractor, and with different histories in different climates and soils, we discovered that those who sow can live, can survive, and can feed humanity for millennia. Despite the changes and developments in our societies, these family farmers were able to feed the world in the past and still have the capacity to secure our future. The real issue may not be about who will feed us tomorrow, but how our societies will help those who sow to be able to cultivate our future.
Je viens semer quelques graines sur le terreau des idées, rendre hommage à ceux qui s'aiment et nourrissent l'humanité. Je viens questionner les hommes, l'avenir de nos sociétés, regarder autour du globe et voir germer les idées. Je viens semer quelques graines sur le terreau des idées, rendre hommage à ceux qui s'aiment et nourrissent l'humanité. Je viens questionner les hommes, l'avenir de nos sociétés, regarder autour du globe et voir germer les idées. Immobile sur sa terre, il est assis, le regard qui s'égare sur l'horizon et sans égard sur ses pieds. La terre se met à trembler, elle aussi, lorsque le marché vacille. Paysan dans le brouillard du marché, et ses mouvements incessants, l'excédent de production à sacrifier, sa récolte, conclusion d'une concurrence inconsidérée.